In this video tutorial, I am going to discuss about enzyme specificity. Remember, enzymes are highly selective for their substrate. They don't just act randomly on any substrate, and that's why we can say that enzymes are highly specific molecules. Now, enzymes shows two different types of specificity. The first one is the stereospecificity. Stereospecificity, and second one is the geometric specificity. Let's first look at the stereospecificity. Remember, stereospecificity is related to the stereoisomers. Now, regarding stereoisomers, I had discussed in a great detail in a playlist of carbohydrate chemistry. So, if you want to know more about the stereoisomers, you can refer to that playlist. Coming back to stereoisomers, simply put, stereoisomers are those compounds which have similar molecular formula or same molecular formula, but three-dimensionally, they are mirror images to each other. For example, D-glucose and L-glucose. This D-glucose and L-glucose both have same molecular formula, but both are mirror images of each other. Now, the example of stereospecificity. For example, we have enzyme glucokinase. This enzyme glucokinase, it acts only on the D-glucose. It does not act on L-glucose. So, we can say glucokinase is a stereospecific, right? Now, in this stereospecificity, almost all enzymes show stereospecificity except for the enzyme commission class number 5, and that is isomerases. So this class of enzyme, they does not show any stereospecificity. The second specificity is the geometric specificity. Here the enzymes are specific to chemical group or bond present in the substrate. Now, under the geometric specificity, there are three groups are there according to level of their geometric specificity. The first group is the absolute substrate specificity. The second one is the relative substrate specificity. And the third one is the broad substrate specificity. Now, first let's look at the absolute substrate specificity. Here, this is very narrow range of specificity. Here, only one substrate is there for the enzyme. And again, here also, example is the glucokinase. As we know, glucokinase has only one substrate, and that is D-glucose. The second example is the urease. This enzyme, it acts only on the urea, no any other substrate. So their range of specificity is very, very narrow, and that's why we call it as an absolute substrate specificity. The second one is the relative substrate specificity. Here, enzymes are little bit more permissive. Here, enzymes, they are specific to group. They are specific to group or bond present in the substrate. Just to understand more, let's look at the example. The first example is the trypsin. Now here, trypsin, it is an enzyme which can break down peptide bond, but it does not break down any peptide bond. Rather, trypsin identifies arginine or lysine. When these amino acids are identified, then the peptide bond which involves these amino acids, only those peptide bonds are broken down, right? And arginine and lysine both have similar type of group, and that is a basic group. Both are classified under basic amino acid, right? So here we can say that trypsin is a specific group related specificity is there. The second example is the glycosidase. Now this enzyme, what it does, glycosidase, it breaks down glycosidic bond. Okay, so this glycosidase is a bond specific, right? And this trypsin is a specific group related specificity is there. The third type of geometric specificity is the broad substrate specificity. Here, enzyme acts on a large number of substrate. Here the substrate range is very, very wide. They may not be even related with the specific group or bond. Let us look at the example. Here the first example is the hexokinase. Now hexokinase, it acts on hexose sugars, and these hexose sugars may be glucose, fructose, mannose, like that. It also acts on sugar amines. For example, glucosamine. So as we can see that even structurally unrelated hexose as well as sugar amines, those compounds are also acted upon by the same enzyme, right? So here the variety of substrate is very wide. The second example is the carboxypeptidase A. Now this carboxypeptidase A, it breaks down C-terminal peptide bond. So in a polypeptide chain, suppose this is the polypeptide chain where multiple amino acids or polymer of amino acid is there. Suppose this is the N-terminal and this is the C-terminal. So what happened? This C-terminal amino acid, it is being released by breaking down this its immediate peptide bond. Okay, now these amino acid, it can be any amino acid except for arginine, proline and lysine. If these three amino acids are not there at the C terminal side, then this peptide bond will be broken down and that particular amino acid will be released. So here once again you can say that carboxypeptidase has very wide variety of substrate. Now looking at the broad substrate specificity, it seems that these enzymes are not specific, right? So remember, this broad substrate specificity is not a rule. Rather, it is considered as an exception. Okay? So most of all the enzymes, they are highly specific in their action. I hope that everything is clear about enzyme specificity. If you have any query or confusion, please write it down in the comment section below. Thank you.